Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at the four techniques you need to master to be more productive on your Mac. So there are certain basic actions that every Mac user knows. For instance, you know to click to select something, double click to open something up, you can click and drag to move things around. But there are some slightly more advanced actions that you need to be able to master to really be productive on your Mac. Most of the questions I get about how to do something or where something's located really come down to just understanding these actions and how to use them. So the first one I want to talk about is drag and drop. And a lot of people know this is there, but they don't realize how much you can use it in all sorts of situations. So for instance, if I wanted to drag this file into a folder, of course you would drag and drop it into the folder. And most people know to do that. But there are so many other ways you can use drag and drop, so let's look at some examples. Say you want to export a photo from the Photos app into a file, and you may select one and then look for export functions and things like that. It's much simpler. You can just drag and drop. So here I've got a Finder window. Here I've got the Photos app. I drag a photo here and it exports it and puts it as a file there. And that's all you need to do. You can even do it for a group of photos. So I can select two photos here, drag and drop, and it exports them into the Finder. You can see them both there. So that's really easy. You can also use them to bring photos into things. So for instance, let's look at Pages, and I've got a blank document here, and I could drag this photo into the document and it appears. Pretty easy. You can also open up things using the dock and dragging and dropping there. So for instance, this text file here, normally would, if I would double click it, would open up in TextEdit. But say I wanted to open up in Pages instead, I can drag to the dock, go over to Pages, drop it on Pages, and now it opens up the text document in Pages rather than TextEdit. You can do things like say, what happens if I would drag and drop this PDF to Mail? What's going to happen then? What will happen then is it actually creates a composition window, puts the document there, and this would happen with an image as well, and puts my cursor right there on the two lines so I can start addressing this PDF to go to whoever I want. You could also, if you were creating a composing something here and you wanted to drag and drop something into that, like I wanted to do an attachment, instead of using the attachment button or some menu item, you can drag and drop into a mail composition window like that. You can put a PDF in there, a text file, any file you want into it. You can do even things like system preferences. Under System Preferences, you've got Desktop and Screensaver, and you've got this little drop zone here. And if I wanted to drag and drop, you can see I got that little plus button there. I can make this picture my desktop background simply by dragging and dropping in there. So a lot of people get confused. How do I do it? Is there a button for me to be able to do this? No. You just drag and drop onto the obvious thing to perform the action with the file that you wanted. You know, you can even, instead of going to the Finder or from the Finder, you can go directly sometimes from app to app. So here on a web page, for instance, if I wanted to go and take an image and put it in a Pages document, I open the Pages document, I open Safari, and I say take this image here. I can drag right from Safari right into Pages. So I didn't have to actually go and go use the Finder as an intermediary. You can go between apps. Now the next thing you need to master is using menus. So the menus are always at the very top of the screen, and there are usually tons of options wherever you are. So here I am in the Finder. If I want to go into an app like Pages, there are tons of options here, and there are menus with submenus, and those submenus have submenus and things like that. So there are plenty of functions in here, and most of the time when somebody asks me how to do something, there's actually a menu item for it. They just haven't taken the time to look through it. So I encourage you not only to search through it and try to make sense of these here. If you're trying to format text, obviously all the options are going to be under format. But other things like sometimes the window menu and the view menu could seem like they have similar types of functions. So it's just important to just be patient and look through these menu items to find what you want. It's usually there. Now there is a trick though that you can use to find something quickly. It's this help menu here. Help menu here has got search, and you would think that search would search documentation, and it does, but it also searches for the menu items. So for instance, let's say if I wanted to type some text here and I want to make this 77 squared. So I want to do superscript here. And I know there's a menu item here for superscript, but where is it? Well, I don't have to actually search for it beyond going to help and starting to type superscript. And as soon as I start typing it, you can see it comes with menu items and baseline superscript. And it actually will, if I roll over it, it'll show me where it is. So I can see it's there under format, under baseline, and there's superscript. And I can actually select it from here, or I could leave this help menu and go and find it on my own. So the third technique is the context menu. So what's the context menu? Well, the universal way to get to a context menu is select something and then control click on it. Use the control key, not the command key, but the control key on your keyboard, and click on it, and it brings up this, which is called a context menu. The reason it's called that is because it contains commands that pertain to what you have selected. So for instance, let me hide pages here and go into the Finder, and I can select a document. I can control click on it, and I can see things that pertain to this as a document. You can open it, you can open it with, I can compress it, I can rename it, things that make sense for a file. And this works in all sorts of different situations. I go to photos, I can control click on a photo, and I can see things that pertain to this photo. So many functions are easy to get to if you just control click on the item, but people forget that you can control click on almost anything. Now, I say control click. If you go to System Preferences and you go to either trackpad or mouse, I have a trackpad hooked up to this Mac, so I'll go to trackpad. What you'll find is it's called secondary click. And secondary click on a trackpad, I can change it, and I could set it to tap with two fingers, bottom right corner, bottom left corner. If this were the mouse, not trackpad, I was setting, I could set secondary click to be the right click if there's a right mouse button, or the right side of a button. Right side of the single button that is on an Apple mouse, that is. So I can set the secondary click up to be anything I want. The one universal place that you'll find it is by holding the control key down and clicking. No matter how you have things set, that's always going to bring up the context menu. So it's important to master the context menu and always think of it as a go-to. When you need to do something, you don't know how to do it right away, try control clicking on the item that you're trying to do something with and see what comes up. Sometimes not only is it the easiest way to get to something, but sometimes it's the only way to perform certain functions. Now the fourth technique is copy and paste. Now you may think you have this one down already, right? Because you're in a document here, you select some text, you command C to copy, you go somewhere else, you command V to paste, and you've done it. But copy and paste could be used for so much more than text. For instance, in the Finder here, you can select a file and you can copy that file. Go somewhere else and you can paste it. And you've just made a copy of that file there. So you can use copy and paste for files. You can use copy and paste for all sorts of other things. For instance, I can go into this numbers document here and say, oh, this is a great chart. I want to put this in my pages document that I'm composing. I can select it, I can copy it, and you know what? I can go over to Pages, a completely different app, and I can paste. And it pastes that entire chart. Not only does it paste it, it's not just a graphic. I can actually edit the chart data here, and you can see it's picked up the data. So it actually really has pasted this as an object, not just a graphic. So you can use copy and paste for tons of different things in tons of different places. And when you need to get something from one place to another place on your Mac, you may want to try copy and paste, because very commonly that's the simplest way to do it too. So there are the four techniques that you need to master to be productive on your Mac. You need to learn how to drag objects and drop them places. You need to learn how to look through the menus and use the help search to find menu commands. You need to learn how to control click on items to bring up context menus. And you need to learn how to copy and paste items. Once you master those four techniques, you'll be able to do so much more on your Mac and so much more efficiently.